incentivizing alternative fuel vehicles. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me is Pennsylvania State Representative Greg Vitali. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks for hosting, Jill.
There is a program called the Alternative Fuels Incentive Program that's currently in place in Pennsylvania. It's been in place since the 1990s. Talk to us about the purpose of the program.
Yeah, AFIG. It's a very valuable program. It's small, but it's valuable. It's funded by the gross receipts tax, a 2.25 mils, which is around $6 million a year. What it does is provide monies to incent alternative fuel vehicles like electric vehicles, vehicles run on biofuels, vehicles run on compressed natural gas, and so forth. The purpose of the program is one, to keep us independent, energy independent. You know, the less gasoline we use in our vehicles, the more independent we are from the Middle East and those people. Also, air pollution issues. You know, electric vehicles are very clean. Compressed natural gas vehicles are cleaner than gasoline vehicles, as are biofuels. So less air pollution, energy independence, also economic development. These programs by developing these homegrown Pennsylvania industries, you're creating jobs. So that's the purpose of the program.
So who qualifies to participate in this program?
Municipalities, school districts, other entities like that. For example, my school district, the Haverford Township School District, gets AFIG money to help it buy biofuels for its bus fleet. Radnor Township, Lower Merion School District received about a $300,000 AFIG grant to buy 13 compressed natural gas buses. AFIG, there are charging stations, five charging stations, electric charging stations in this region, two in Radnor, one in Media, one in King of Prussia, and one in Philly that were put there by AFIG money. So it's money that benefits, that is out there benefiting us all, and it's really sort of creating the infrastructure to develop this alternative fuel vehicles.
So in terms of the money that is being utilized with this program, some of it incentivizes municipalities, as you mentioned, to use natural gas for fleets and other vehicles. But you also mentioned charging stations, and that's been part of the concern when it comes to these alternate fuel vehicles, that the infrastructure isn't necessarily
there in
terms of refueling.
Yeah, that's why it's so key to sort of have this public money to sort of get more charging stations out there. It's kind of like the chicken and the egg. I mean, you can't produce the cars without the charging stations, and there's no sense putting charging stations without the cars. So you kind of have to sort of develop it sort of at the same time, and that's why the AFIG program is so valuable. The state seems to be all about natural gas now, but that really doesn't help you with electric vehicles, because electric vehicles, they are not something that lend themselves. There's something that can be charged in your own house. They don't really lend themselves to compressed natural gas, the individual personal cars we use.
Now, this money from the Alternative Fuels Incentive Program is different from the Act 13 money and the incentive money that had been part of that program.
Yeah, that whole Marcellus Shale impact fee money, that will not help electric vehicles at all, or many compressed natural gas vehicles, because there are certain qualifications that put these smaller fleet vehicles, they don't qualify for that. So the Act 13 money really does not really help. It's not really a substitute for AFIG, and that's why there's such a movement now from people benefiting by this program to make sure that program remains strong.
Now, with the Alternative Fuels Incentive Program, there has been a movement, as you've mentioned, for people who are proponents of this program to keep it in place. But you mentioned it is a small program and you'd like it to stay.
Like it to stay because it leverages a lot of public and other private money.
Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
We've been talking with Pennsylvania State Representative Greg Vitali. I'm Jill Horner.